Namaste, dear yogis. Welcome to join in for this yin and yang class to help relieve stress, to help you get that release, a different type of a release that is emotional, mental and spiritual. This will, kick start that healing process within you. It is a combination of yin yoga poses, which is held a little bit longer. They're very soothing and calming. And then, of course, few yang poses, which are a little bit more dynamic and strengthening. So roll out your mat, get comfortable. Let's get started. Wonderful. So all you need for this class is a yoga block. So if you do not have a yoga block at home, I do recommend, for example, grabbing a big book and maybe cover it in a towel if you want to. If you do have a pillow, a large cushion pillow, that might work as well. So we're going to start out in Shavasana, getting all nice and reclined. Your feet hips width apart. We're going to bring our hands down to the sides and close our eyes for a moment. So just feel your breath coming in and out. Your belly rising with your inhalation and falling as you exhale. With every exhalation, release tension, release stress. Not only physical tension, but also emotional, mental tension. Notice how the body becomes lighter as you surrender. Feeling a sense of happiness within you, calmness. Allow your breathing to become a bit more deeper. Breathing in, count to five. And breathing out, count to five. Good. Now you can turn your palms down, keeping your arms next to your body. Bend your knees and keep your feet about hips width apart. Take a nice deep breath in, reaching your arms above your head. Good. And as you exhale, bring your arms back down next to your body. Press the lower back into the floor. Again, inhaling, reaching those arms above your head. And exhale, press the lower back into the floor as you bring your arms down. One last time, inhaling, arms up. And exhale, relax. Good job. With the next inhalation, start to lift those hips up from the floor. As you exhale, bring them back down. Two more times. Inhaling vertebrae by vertebrae, bring your knees forward as you exhale, coming back down. Last one, inhaling up and exhaling down. Good job. Swing your knees side to side, releasing any tension from the lower back. such a beautiful evening here in Finland. Looking at that sky, clouds, clear sky otherwise. Beautiful. Summer night. Good. Bring your right ankle down to your left thigh. Nice. And recline pigeon pose. You can either stay here or bring that right hand in between your legs, hugging that left knee in towards your chest. Good. You can rock yourself slightly side to side again. Woo! Almost rocked over. Good. And just continue. Sometimes when some poses feel so incredibly releasing, just a smile comes to my face. It's hard to stop smiling because it feels so good to take care of the body and also take care of our soul and mind. Good. Slow down and release that left foot down. Nice. Other side. So right foot down, bring that left ankle down to your right thigh. Again, either staying here and gently swinging your legs side to side, or bring that left hand in between your legs, hug your right knee into your chest and hold it there. Again, gently swinging side to side. Good. And release the right foot down, release the left foot down. Beautiful. Just for a moment, hug your knees into your chest. Again, gently rocking yourself side to side. Good. And from here, you can either turn to your side and come up into a cross-legged seated position, or if you wish, you can just rock yourself up and sit up. Beautiful. We shall continue. Bring your hands down to your knees. Take another moment with some lovely deep breaths. Close your eyes, relax your shoulders, breathing in deeply. And as you exhale, empty your lungs completely. One more time, breathing in and exhaling completely. Good. Bring your chin down to your chest and slowly right ear towards the right shoulder. Bring your head back up. Go over to the left side, like drawing a big circle with your head. And chin down to your chest one more time, bringing your head up, center, over to your left, and down. Good. And other way, so go over to your left side, center, right side, and down. One more, left. Center, over to your right, and down. Good. Release your hands down to your sides. Take a deep breath in, reaching your arms up towards the sky. Good. Exhale, interlock your fingers behind your head. Good. Inhale, lift the chest, look up. Exhale, round your spine and bring your elbows together. Again, inhaling, open your chest and exhaling round. Last one, inhale and exhale round. Good. Inhale, come back to the center. Bring your hands to your shoulders and this time draw a wide big circle up and through the back down. One more time, bring the elbows together, up and down. And also the other way, going up Bring your elbows together, down, and one last time, up. Good, together and down. Nice. Let's take one little calming pose in between of our flowing. So coming into fire log pose, you can have your right shin in front of the left, or if you prefer, you can have your right shin on top of that left. Good. And holding in here, you can always use a block, for example. You can place the block in between your knees. Good. And we're gonna go slowly into a forward fold. So just reaching yourself down. Hold it there. I recommend highly to keep your ankles flexed. This creates a bit of a protection to your knees, knee joints. So in a pigeon pose, this is also known as a double pigeon pose. So protect those joints. Keep the ankles flexed. Good, hold it there, breathe. One more deep breath in and exhale. Good. And then slowly walk yourself back up. Nice. Reaching your hands behind you. Keep your feet about hip width apart and just swing your knees side to side like windshield wipers. Nice. Let's do the other side. So this time, either your left shin in front of the right. As you can see, knees are on top of my heels. Or just bringing your left shin on top of that right one. Good. And again, nice, calm. If you would like to have a bit of a more intense pose, you can come into a forward fold. Good, hold it there. Just relax and let go. Try to observe your body and notice where you're holding on to that tension. It might be your jaw, it might be your shoulders, it doesn't even have to be your hips. So try to really observe yourself. Forget about your surroundings. And gaze inwards. Good. And slowly coming back up. Nice. Again, release your legs, hands behind you, and just gently releasing any bit of a tension from our hips by swinging the knees side to side. Good. Come back to the center. Nice. Now, let's move on to all fours. So coming onto all fours, making sure that the alignments are correct. Wrists are underneath our shoulders, knees are hips width apart, underneath our hips. And we're gonna start with a couple of cat-cows, as it is such a soothing pose for our spine. So as you exhale, take a gaze into your navel. And as you inhale, lift the tailbone, bring your chest forward, bring your gaze forward. Again, exhaling, rounding your spine. Look into your navel, tuck that tailbone. Inhaling, lift the tailbone, gaze forward. Exhale, round. And inhale, look up. Very good. Coming back onto all fours, we're gonna come into a calf stretch. So you can bring your right leg all the way to the block problems. Good. So right leg all the way to the back, pressing those toes into the ground and pressing that heel away from yourself. Keep your gaze in between your thumbs. Neck is nice and long. Very good. Take your right leg over to your left side. Now, gaze over your left shoulder. Looking into that right heel, you should feel a nice deep stretch through the IT band. Good. Outer hip gets stretched out. Nice. As you come back to that center, we're going to swing that right leg over to the right side. In line with my hip, as you can see. Good. Hold it there. On your inhalation, we're going to bring that right arm up. Nice. Chest gets all opened up. Good. Bring the right hand back down. And this time, we're going to slide the left hand underneath our chest. Good. You can bring your head down. And you can take your right hand over your lower back and grab a hold of your right upper thigh. We aim to look up towards the sky or ceiling or whatever it is above you. Have a look at that. Good. So you can feel those knots opening up in the upper back. Also another option, keeping the right hand over at the front or wherever it is. Good. Hold it there. Nice, supporting with your right hand. We're going to come back to that center and take a step onto all fours. Other side. So left leg over to the back. Again, start to press your heel away. Good. Hold it there. Calf is loving this. Nice. So can you imagine it's 10 o'clock at the night? It's midsummer, so completely endless white nights, endless days, because the sun doesn't set in Scandinavia at the midsummer. So wonderful light time. Sleeping is always fun. Good. Nice. Take your left leg over to your right side. Look over your right shoulder into that left heel. Good, hold it there. Feel that beautiful stretch. Remember your breathing. Prioritize that deep breathing. Get that fresh oxygen into your bloodstream. Good. And then step that left leg over to the left side. Barely made it. Good, didn't end up in a C. Nice. With your next inhalation, reach your left arm up. Good. And down. And then right hand underneath your chest, slide it. Good. Bring the right side of your head down. And again, choose your variation. You can bring that left hand forward. You can bring that left hand over your lower back. Grab a hold of that right upper thigh. Whatever suits you today. Listen to your body. It shall tell you what it wants. That is for sure. Good. Release that left hand down. Come back to the center and step onto all fours again. Wonderful. From our all fours, we're going to tuck the toes and we're going to come into our downward facing dog. Keep your knees nice and bent. Feet are hips width apart. Good. Just stretch out that upper back, or the entire back actually. Try to bring that chest towards your knees. Nice. And then start to shift yourself into your plank pose. From your plank, release the knees. Chest, chin down, coming onto your belly. Good job. Let's come into a Sphinx pose for a moment. just to release any tension from that lower back. Good, a nice and gentle Sphinx pose. So if this does not feel good on your back, please come a little bit closer to the floor. Otherwise, try to keep your elbows underneath your shoulders. Excellent, and breathe here. You can close your eyes if you wish. You can also relax that chin down if you wish. Just breathe. Nothing else to do but enjoy this moment. Whenever you feel anything troubling your mind or your mind drifting away from your practice, then just bring it back to your breath. The breath, it's like a bridge between our body and our mind. So use that breath to keep yourself present. Nice. From here, just lower yourself down. Just for a moment, relax that forehead down to your hands. Good. Now, if you do have any lower back problems with the next pose, keep your hands quite far away. So about mat width apart, fingers are separated, index fingers pointing forward. We're going to engage those glutes. We're going to press down through the tops of our feet. And on an inhalation, we're going to look up, lift up. Exhaling down. Now, if you wish, you can bring your hands a little bit closer. Inhaling, we're gonna roll up. And exhale, we're gonna relax down. And we're gonna repeat this four more times. Inhaling, just slowly lifting up. Keep the buttocks engaged, tuck that tailbone. Exhaling down. And inhaling up. Listen to the boundaries that your body is giving you. If it's hurting, come closer to the ground. If you want to challenge yourself, then come up a little bit higher. Good. Exhale down. Last one. Inhaling up. And exhaling down. Good. Bring your hands just next to your sides. And slowly push yourself back into your child's pose. Hips back, forehead down to the ground. Hands either in the front or bringing your hands next to your body. Breathe and relax. Allow that back to stretch out. Good, and from your child's pose, let's come into our downward facing dog, reaching your hands over to the front. Spread your fingers wide, tuck your toes, and lift the hips and push the hips back. Good, nice long spine, nice strong arms. Engage your core, tuck that tailbone. Good. Let's look into our fingers and take that little baby steps to the front of our mats. Good. Exhale again, releasing your head down. Inhale, bring your hands on your shins. Take a half lift. Exhale, fold down. Inhale, bring your arms all the way up. Exhale, release the hands to your heart center. Good, let's carry on into the yang part of the practice. Inhaling, reaching your arms up. Exhale, take a forward fold. Inhale, have a look up. And exhale, step your right foot over to the back. Nice. We're gonna inhale into a high lunge. Good, keeping your feet about hip width apart. Keep the gaze steady. We're gonna take cactus arms. Good, exhaling here. Inhaling, reaching your arms up. One more time. Exhale, elbows to the sides. Inhaling, arms up. As you exhale, interlock your fingers behind your back. Take a deep breath, then squeeze those shoulder blades together. We're gonna release that right knee down, top of the foot down. Good, hold it there. Bring those hips forward and down. Try to tuck that tailbone to get a deeper stretch through the hip flexor. On your next inhalation, reaching your arms up. Grab a hold of your right wrist and exhale, take a side bend to your left. Inhaling to the center and exhale, release the hands down and shift the hips back. Good, half monkey pose. Nice, in here again, as you know, I love to talk about the alignments, but check. Always there, ankle is flexed, and engage your core. Try to avoid this rounding the back, but try to lift your heart, relax the shoulders. Good. One more deep breath. Nice. Inhale, start to bend your left knee. Tuck the toes on the right side, lift that right knee. We're gonna come into a side lunge, walking the hands over to the right side of your mat. And you can just side lunge up here a bit higher, or you can sit down all the way. Good, holding in here. You can always bring those palms together to your heart center, or keep your hands down on the ground. Good, coming into our wide-legged forward fold. So just lift yourself up, turn the toes lightly in. As you inhale, come into a half lift. And as you exhale, bring the crown of the head down towards the earth. Shift the weight towards the front of your foot. Hold and breathe. Again, remember to keep that core engaged to support your lower back. Good. Beautiful. With your next inhalation, we're gonna come into a half lift. And as you exhale, we're gonna walk over to the front of our mat into a low lunge. Beautiful. And from our low lunge, we're gonna take a bit of a bounce. We're gonna bring that right shin on the floor and we're gonna sit down. How smooth was that? Left foot steps over that right thigh. Now, if this feels uncomfortable, we're gonna show it also from the front. Left foot outside that right thigh. If this feels uncomfortable, please straighten that right leg. Good. As you inhale, we're going to reach up through the right arm. As you exhale, bend that right elbow. Take it outside that left thigh. Take your left hand behind your back. Hold and breathe. Grow taller through your spine. Open up your heart. Open up your chest. Good. As you come back to that center, take a hold of your left foot with your right arm, and we're going to lengthen that left foot forward. We're going to take that left hand behind our back. So again, showing from the front, left foot is forward, holding on with our right hand, left hand towards the back of our mat. Nice straight spine. Good, shoulders are in line. Beautiful. Come back to that center. Release that left foot. Bring that right foot against the inner thigh, left inner thigh. Flex that left ankle. Inhale, reach your arms up. And exhale, fold forward. Hold it here. With an inhalation, micro movement, you're gonna lengthen your spine. As you exhale, you're gonna release and relax. It is so calming, this class, that I can actually feel myself talking super calmly. If you have noticed me in a vinyasa class, my speech is a bit faster. But look at this. Isn't life gorgeous? And isn't this planet just a paradise? I love it. Love it. Good. On your next inhalation, strong core, we're going to reach those arms up. Exhale, right hand behind your back. And inhale, lift those hips up. Good. Feel that stretch in the hip flexors. Nice. Good. Hold it there for a moment. And relax down. Good job. Now from here, we're going to swing those legs over to the back again and coming into our downward facing dog. Good, just pedal out. Nice. Both heels down, and then looking into our fingers and walking ourselves up towards the front of our mat. Exhale, release the forehead down. Inhale, reach your arms up. And exhale, fold forward immediately over to the other side. Good. Inhale, look up. Exhale, step your left foot all the way to the back. Low lunge. On an inhalation, coming up to a high lunge. Good. Find your balance. Feet are hips width apart. Good. Next exhalation, cactus arms, elbows to the sides. As you inhale, reaching up. Exhale, elbows. Inhale, reach your arms up. Exhale, interlock your fingers behind your back. Inhale, squeeze those shoulder blades together. Hold and breathe, and slowly release that left knee down, top of the foot down. Good. Try to bring those hips slightly forward and down, keeping your knee above your ankle. On your next inhalation, reach your arms up. Take a hold of your left wrist and exhale. Take a side bend to your right. Inhaling, coming back to the center. Exhale, release the hands down and shift the hip back to your half monkey pose. Good. Now really try to visualizing bringing that seating bone on the right side towards the back. So you want to align those hips, visualizing the heel and the knee coming together. Good. Drawing in towards like magnets. Keep breathing, keep that back straight. Nice. With our next inhalation, let's bend that right knee. Tuck the left toes, lift that left knee. We're going to come into a side lunge on the left side. So you're going to walk your hands over to the left side, back of your mat. And you can stay up higher or you can sit all the way down. Good. So nice. Either bringing your hands together or keeping your hands on the floor or wherever it feels suitable and comfortable. Good. Lift the right toes up towards the sky. Nice, and moving into our wide-legged forward fold, lifting those hips up. I'm just gonna turn towards you so you can see what I'm doing. Again, inhaling, lifting your gaze. Exhaling, releasing down. This time we're gonna keep that left palm down. As you inhale, bring your right arm up towards the sky. Good. Try to stack those shoulders. Try to root down through both of your legs so your hips don't go really, you know, off. Good. Release the right hand down. Change it around. Lift the left arm up. Lots of boat racing going on tonight. Bye-bye silence. Good. And release it down. Beautiful. Coming into your low lunge. Now I'm gonna swap those legs around again so you can see what I'm actually doing the right way. Good. So you're in a low lunge with your right leg in front. So we're gonna take that bit of a bounce and we're gonna bring that left shin to the floor. Nice. Let's step that right foot outside that left thigh. Nice straight back. Inhaling, start to reach out through that left arm. Exhale, engage that core as you take your twist. Your left elbow outside that right thigh. Your right hand behind your back. Your chest is open, and as you inhale, you lengthen up through the top of your head. As you exhale, you gaze towards the back of your mat. Keep breathing. Stay happy, stay positive. It's all about the mindset in everything. Good. Nice. Inhale, come back to the center. We're gonna take a hold of our right foot with our left hand. Lengthen that right leg over to the front. Lengthen your spine and take your right hand towards the back of your mat. Keep breathing. Good. It's nice balancing pose, especially when the waves decided to come in. Not really waves, I might say. Good. Nice. Come back to the center. Release that right leg. Bring the left sole against the right inner thigh. Flex that right foot. Inhale. Take a deep breath in as you inhale. And as you exhale, start to fold down. Good. First inhalation, lengthen your spine. Look up to your toes. And exhale, soften. Good. Again, that micro movement. Inhalation, lengthening the spine. Exhalation, relaxing down. When you're in a forward fold like this, a bit of a point here with that hamstring stretch, visualize the inside of your foot pressing forward. So what often happens is that the outside goes forward or the foot falls over to the side. So we want to have the knees, toes facing upward. We want to press forward throughout that entire foot, especially the big toe. Good. As you inhale, reaching your arms up. And as you exhale, take your left hand behind your back. Again, let's take that bit of a reverse supported plank. Hold it there, open up your heart, stretch out that hip flexor. Keep breathing. Oh, the waves are coming. Good, and release it down. Beautiful, so we're not gonna go back into our downward facing dog from here anymore, but we are going to lie down and we're going to get ready for the final postures. So lying all the way down to our back. Nice. So now if you do have your block or your book or your cushion, grab it. We're going to bend the knees. We're going to lift those hips up and place that block underneath our hips. Good. So let's turn those palms up and just take a moment here. Before you do anything, enjoy that moment where the hips are higher than our heart. Close your eyes and just breathe. From here, let's take that right knee into our chest, interlocking our fingers on top of our knee, and lengthen that left leg out, left heel down to the ground. Hold it here for a moment. We're gonna swap the legs around, so place your right foot down, hug that left knee into your chest, lengthen your right leg out, hold it there for a moment. Good. And now we're going to lengthen both legs out. If you do have lower back issues, then I recommend highly that you keep your knees bent, or you can do it just lying down on the ground without a block or anything. Otherwise, adjust your block so it's nice and supporting you. Good. Lengthen out your legs. If you do want to, you can have your hands on your side. You can have your hands above your head. I like to sometimes grab a hold of my elbows and stay here. Feel that chest opening up too. And we'll take just a little moment in here, relaxing, enjoying opening up those hips, stretching out the hip flexors, and gaining a lot of peace with this. Slowly start to release your hands back down. We're going to bend our knees. Just lift the hips a little bit and bring that block or book a bit higher towards that lower back. Hold for a moment. And And then lift your feet off the floor, knees towards the chest. Good. And then let's lengthen those legs up towards the sky. Good. You can circle your ankles a bit, both ways, releasing any tension that has collected into those ankles. Good. Nice. And from here, we're going to slowly, you can even support with your hands. We're going to slowly open up the legs into a wide-legged bit of a split here. Good. Holding in here. You can have your hands on the inside or on the outside of your thighs, whatever suits you the best. And again, just breathe. This is such a lovely stretch. It's just wonderful, wonderful. Having the legs up, just feeling the body healing. It's beautiful, giving our heart a bit of a break from pumping all that blood to our feet. Good. Nice. And slowly, slowly, we're going to bring those legs back up. Bit of an inner thigh workout. And bend those knees. Release the feet down. Lift your hips and remove the block. And hug your knees into your chest. Good, nice. Swing side to side. Massage that back a bit. Good. And take your hands down to the sides now. Oh, and we're going to take the knees over to our right side as we're going to take the gaze over to our left side. Good. Again, here, option, you can use a cushion or a block in between your knees or below that knee. If you feel any tension in the lower back, if you feel the shoulders coming off the floor, then do that. Otherwise, just stay here. If you do feel you need a more intense stretch, you can bind that left knee over your right. Good, and just relax and relax and relax and enjoy. You want a more stretch for the chest area. Reach that left arm a bit higher. Good. Let's come back to the center. Head to the center. Again, you can swing those knees side to side a bit. You can hug them if you wish. Waves, waves and waves. Good. Let's do the other side. So as the knees go over to your left side, oh, there's a bit of a nails here. And head to your right. And relax. Again, many options. You can use a block. You can even stack that left hand on top of that right thigh for a bit of a support. Or you can bind your knees. Except I'm gonna fall off into a C again. Main thing what we want to is that the back is feeling safe and the shoulders stay on the floor. Good. And that we can actually relax into the pose. Sometimes we might go so far into the pose that there is no possible way to relax. So that's what I want you to do. Find a pose where you can enjoy yourself and relax. You can feel the benefits, you can feel the healing. Good, and let's come back to the center. Hug yourself nice and tight, and again, swinging yourself side to side. We're going to go into the sweet land of Shavasana next. So get settled. If you want to use a cushion underneath your head or underneath your thighs, go grab your cushion. Otherwise, lengthen your legs in towards the corners of your mat. Bring your arms down to the sides with your palms facing upwards. Take a deep breath in. And as you exhale, close your eyes, soften yourself, sink into your mat. Repeat this, take a deep breath in through the nostrils. And this time exhale through your mouth. Repeat this as many times necessary to release the tension. And then when you feel that you're relaxed, then just enjoy. Allow the breath to settle into the natural rhythm. Let's take this moment together. Keep your eyes still closed. Don't move yet. But just for a moment, try to visualize yourself merging with the universe. There is not only you and the nature and the universe, but it's all one. So just feel that unity for a while. And Don't open your eyes yet. Don't move yourself. Just take this short moment. Just feeling this sense of unity. Become one with the universe. Just for a while. All there is oneness. The unity of the body, mind and soul. The unity with the nature around you. The unity with the entire planet, with the entire universe. Start to move your fingers, feel your body, move your toes and your head side to side. Bring your feet together, lengthen your arms above your head, take a deep breath in, the deepest breath of the day. And as you exhale, bend your knees and turn to your right side. Good. Take a moment on your right side. And with your eyes closed, come up into a cross-legged seated position. Bring your hands to your heart center. Feel the sense of gratitude within yourself for the practice you just did. Feel gratitude for your body, for your health, for your breath, for your heartbeat. Feel gratitude for the people in your life. For all the magic. I'm grateful that you came and practiced with me today. Namaste. You can open up your eyes. Thank you for taking this time. Thank you truly from my heart that you decided to practice yoga with me, and it really makes me smile. Thank you. And I hope you have unwind yourself. I hope you feel stress less and calmer and happier. And yes, have a lovely, lovely day or evening or night, whatever the time is, wherever you are. So I shall see you in the next classes. Thank you. Peace out.